Hey guys.
Oh my god, you're...
You're
such a manly girl. Your eyebrows move as well when you talk. So sexy.
No.
Come, let's go to a bush together. So the DayZ standalone is here in Early Access Alpha, so I thought I'd give it a go. I actually have already played One Life at Nighttime, which is my dude here, but Rocket's reset all the servers. Rocket is the lead dev on this game, so I'm going to have none of this stuff, I believe, when I log in. But I had a beautiful M4. Look, it's got like a different grip and everything. Big backpack, a gas mask, and a head torch on my gas mask. I probably won't manage to get all this stuff in this video. But I'm just going to show you starting off, give you some tips how to get going. And without further ado, in fact, before some further ado, I'm just going to show you my video settings, because these are quite important. The game is kind of laggy. In fact, I would say it's somewhat more laggy, especially in cities, than it was previously. So, objects and terrain, I'd put those on very low, because they're very laggy, as is clouds. Shadows doesn't need to make any difference, at least for me. Textures, you can just leave those on very high. Put your video memory on auto, because if not, it might not use it all. Rendering, that's laggy for some reason. It wasn't in the in Armor 2. HDR is also quite laggy, as is ambient occlusion and post process. I don't really understand why these are more laggy than they were in Armor 2 in the mod, but they just are for some reason in this. So I've had to disable those. I literally can't play in cities without dropping to like 10 frames per second. The rest is pretty standard. In fact, unfortunately, acceleration can't be disabled, even though I asked Rocket to disable it, like, I don't know, 4 months ago, and he said it was, but it's not yet. So maybe that's something that's going to be fixed. I kind of hope it is, because it sort of wrecks the gunplay a little bit with acceleration on. I don't know if you found that. Some of you probably don't even, not even bothered by that, but I'm playing as the Jamaican gingerbread man today. For some reason, I'm just making gingerbread today, but I don't know what's up with that. Let's get started. Waiting for host. Now, this is quite lucky. Usually... Did we get in? We got in! And as you can see, I'm back at the shore with nothing, unfortunately, because they have reset everything. Now, of course, I know where I am, because I've played this game a long time now. And I don't know why we can't get in there. I wish we could. But we are sort of just in between. I believe this is Komoromo. No, this is probably Kamenka. We're down on the far west side of the map somewhere. So I don't actually know where I am. But I'm just going to show you what the adventure looks like. You press G for this. I think you can take this off. So manly. And it disappears. Not a good start. Fortunately, there are clothes everywhere. And you can kind of press G to look in your vicinity like this. To see what's around. But I was going to show you how to rip that up, but it just looks like it's disappeared through the floor. Anyway. Look far more manly than this white top. So, they've added in a little jump as well. You should also, in your control options, let me just show you this in case you're new. Bind your run to turbo. It goes a little bit faster. If you wonder why some people run a bit faster than you, they've probably done that rather than have it on fast forward. So bind something to that. Now this house, I swear this house never has anything in. And this was the one Rocket demonstrated as, you know, actually having stuff in. With loads of cans of beans at some point during the development process. I'm just going to have a quick look here. I'm basically just going to play flat for 35-40 minutes. I don't expect to find anything here, and I'm not going to run across to Cherno. Can I put these on? Yay! Some more pants! So they've got 6 slots, these pants have only got 4. So what I want to do is put my flashlight and my torch into there, and then switch them across. You can just drag and drop like that, and you see I didn't even have to scroll on that, I can just press the G button. Which is nice, because the scroll menu doesn't work half the time, as you can see, so... And a weapon already! So you drag the weapons across into the top, and you wear it on your back, and then you press 1 to equip it. And this is the raise and lower hand. You can actually swing with both, but I don't think it makes any difference which one you use. There's no upstairs in this one. I think there is a side door here, though. I mean, I'm quite impressed with how the game is at the moment. There are some glaring flaws in it, unfortunately, as you'd expect from an alpha. And I appreciate this is an alpha. Some of these flaws shouldn't be in it still, even though it is an alpha. What is that? You know what I thought? You never know what a... Oh, it's a pen! Oh, you can write notes in this. That's cool. Also, if you can put your battery, if you wondered, into your flashlight, like this. And then if I drag that into slot 2... Anybody comes and kills me, it's gonna be a pain. You could turn it on, and you might think that's... Hang on, you got to press the raise hand button, or it's like that and it's pointing on the side. You're just gonna have to trust me that this is actually on. There's like a little white bit there when it's on, for some reason it doesn't work in daylight. I don't know why, it's just one of those things. And I'm gonna get this can of baked beans as well. I wonder if I can actually open that. No, I can't. You need a sharp object to open it, basically. There's a little bit of a glitch where sometimes it seems to drop your primary weapon, or maybe I'm just not used to things. Like, I'm pressing 1 there and it takes like quite a while to get it out. So it can be a little bit confusing when you first start playing. Is this paper? I know it's an IV Stark kit. It seems there's more loot down here than previously. They patched the game yesterday to fix some exploits people were doing to like hacking gear or whatever. But it seems like there's a bit more loot. Because one of the problems I had the last couple of days playing in the dark, because I was at work, not a good idea having the whole server running at night during the time that everybody is there. You can also drink from these as well. I'm just showing you that. Because my dude is super whiny. He's a bit of a girl. Look how much pond water I've got to drink. Like, seriously, I'm... I had to drink all that pond water to get rid of my thirst. The thirst and the health are a little bit broken at the moment. Dead survivor down there. People are very, very bandity in this as well. In fact, I'll probably show you at the end of this video. The first person I met in the last life I played didn't even have a gun, just shot me. What condition are you in? Badly damaged. And you're damaged. But you see, it's quite nice being able to, and I nearly didn't even see that on there. Some canned tuna. I think you can... Yeah, okay. So I can open the canned tuna because it's got a pull thing on it. And also, you used to require a can opener. I don't know why I'm holding this like a nub. I'll put it away. But you used to need a can opener to open canned goods, but you don't need that anymore. You need anything sharp, basically. But if you say use a hatchet to break open canned goods, then you're going to waste some of the stuff in it. I don't know if there's stuff under these. I've noticed in the barracks you can find like assault rifles and stuff under the beds. A blood stain. Somebody got eaten here. Or got bit, turned into a zombie and then wandered out of here. I kind of wish there was more of that. Sort of more run down things, bits of body parts and not just falling over chairs. My house has got fallen over chairs in it. Doesn't mean there's a zombie apocalypse going on in there. But I kind of wish there was sort of more like physical evidence that a zombie apocalypse had struck. I mean, there aren't many zombies in at the moment. In the mod, I think it's sort of... I don't know if there's some sort of network issue or something like that. They will add more in, but I would be surprised if we perhaps see a couple of zombies on the way up the road. But they have fixed them, because in the DayZ mod, they used to like zigzag all over the place and just be a pain in there. It used to glitch after you, and they've made it into sort of powerful but sort of slow-walking ones now. And that means they might be able to have sort of herds of them, like stumbling through the countryside that you've got to avoid, like they got in The Walking Dead. I'm hoping. Now, if you watch my DayZ series, which I'd imagine quite a lot of you probably do, if you're new to DayZ, I would definitely recommend watching them. I've put the playlist in the description, but watching from the start and like all the way through the episodes, because I run through DayZ like a story, like roleplay that I'm actually in a zombie apocalypse, and it's really cool how it's all structured out, and it shows you a lot of the cool things that you should in the future be able to do in this game here, DayZ Standalone. And if you're a bit confused about that, basically, DayZ originated as a mod by Dean Hall Rocket, the guy I was talking about earlier, for Arma 2 Combined Operations. So it was just a mod for that. But obviously, there were limitations in what you can do in modding another game. So in order to add more stuff in, they've created DayZ Standalone, which is the game that's just come out in alpha on Steam. And there's less in this than there is currently in DayZ Mod. Like, in the episode of DayZ Mod I'm going to post in a couple of days' time, my farm, I built a Herschel's farm. Like, I actually boarded up all the windows and stuff on a farm, put in a gate, got my cars and stuff like that, repaired them all in. And then, early one morning, a tank came and attacked my base and blew it out. So I've had to head over to Namalsk and, you know, I found myself chainsawing my way into somebody else's house because I needed some shot. All that stuff is in DayZ Mod, but there's none of that currently in DayZ Standalone. So don't be put off by the fact that this is seemingly boring gameplay here. It's just that there isn't much in DayZ Standalone at the moment. And if you're wondering where I'm going up this road, I'm not just running randomly out into the countryside. There's a big town called Zelenogorsk on the west side of the map, because we're on the west side at the moment. We're heading pretty much directly north of this road, and it was kind of the last stand by the army against the zombie apocalypse, so there should be some good military loot. I could have headed along the coast, which is down in the direction there, but if I'd done that, I'd have got to Balota Airfield. There's a mask there. A wolf mask. Somebody's definitely... I'm going to get shot now with this on. Somebody's definitely going to think I'm like a baseball bat bandit or something. Well, hopefully I won't meet anybody. There's only 40 people on the server, which really isn't enough at the moment. I'm hoping they're going to increase it, because you need sort of like... I would say you need 60 people on this map to get a decent amount of action. So I don't even know if we're going to be able to find anybody up this road, because it is quite a long run. But as I say, if I headed along the coast towards Balota Airfield and the big city, Chernogorsk, on there, if I run with the sea on my right-hand side, then yeah, there's just going to be a ton of zombies there, and obviously I've got no gear, no food, anything like that, and there's probably going to be a lot of bandits already, because people tend to head to the north of the map, because there's a few airfields and military spaces and stuff like that, and then they get, like, assault rifle is the best one you can get in the game at the moment, is the M4, with, like, I believe a red dot sight on it. You can also get a Mosin sort of rifle that doesn't seem to be, honestly, quite as effective. But they get all that good gear, and then they come back and just shoot new spawns at the beach. They're basically what I would refer to as new bandits. Like, if you're playing like that... Because I think there's sort of like certain stages to your development as a player in this game. You start off not having a clue what you're doing and being like zombie fodder. And then you become like a new bandit where you just shoot whoever you are on sight. Or you perhaps go north with a few of your friends and you can't really survive on your own. And they come back and you shoot a few on the coast and stuff like that. And then you get to the stage where you don't need to shoot people. You know, you actually can hold people up. And that's the highest level you can get in this game. That's the top of the learning curve. You know, where you can actually survive on your own and hold people up without killing them. Because that's what makes the game great, that you can roleplay it like that. I'm a bit disappointed there wasn't anything that hunting up, by the way. I thought there would be some. Maybe loot doesn't spawn there, but there used to be kind of, like, good gear at hunting huts. Because, obviously, at hunting hut, they have, like, rifles and stuff like that. But maybe they're waiting to add some of that in later on. Overall, you know, the game just feels kind of solid and smooth to me. And well, I saw somebody there, but in fact, I've never seen this place before. This didn't used to be on this road, so... This is one of the new things they've added in then, I guess. It's like... It's like an industrial area down here. I'll have a look, see if there's anything decent in it. I don't know if anybody ever been here. It looks quite well hidden, and I can't see any zombies about, so... But they have opened up a lot of these buildings, so... So there's a hospital one across there. And these ones used to be industrial ones on this side, but I think it seems any sort of loot spawns sort of anywhere at the moment. Especially on the shelves. You've got to keep checking the shelves. I don't know what that is. A branch! Where my cursor's gone? It's on the other screen. Oh, it's a wooden stick. I don't think that's going to be good as a baseball bat. But I would say that you are probably... Ooh! Gloves. I keep getting distracted. But I say, are they badly damaged? No, they're just beige. I said badly. You have got to make sure when you're playing this that you check the quality of items you pick up. And when you shoot at people, it actually damages the things that they've got in their jacket and stuff. So if you shoot something in the backpack, it'll damage the stuff in their backpack. If you shoot them in the chest, it'll damage the stuff on like their vest or whatever. So you've got to be quite careful about, you know, it's definitely better in this game to hold people up, even though I've seen... I've actually seen more banditing in this game than I've seen. The first person I met in my previous life just shot at me. So, he didn't even try to talk to me. So, the people aren't quite as friendly as they used to be. But then again, the guns seem to do quite a lot of damage, so there's less incentive to take risks, it seems, for a lot of people. What happened to this poor lady? But the zombies rammed her through the wall. I really want that backpack she's got, though. That's like the big 25 slot one, isn't it? Given you have to drink and eat quite a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, there's somebody near here. I'm actually not sure if there is somebody around here. I have no clue what language that was, but it's part of a gun here, a carry handle. It's worth picking those up until I get a gun, in case the gun I pick up has already been damaged by something, or it got dropped, or, you know, so it's always worth picking up the gun parts, because you can switch them out later on. There's a water bottle there as well. That'll come in useful. I think sometimes it just broadcasts people's voices when they're logging in or something, like just randomly across the whole server. So I don't think that was actually a dude near me, but... because you can talk to anybody in your vicinity, of course, in this game. I'm checking these barracks probably boringly thoroughly. But that is how the game is kind of designed now. Looks like there's a motorbike helmet here. Just put that on top of my mask. As you could just see the little red nose clipping through. I don't want that though. I like the breeze blowing on my ears. It is actually quite a scary mask, this wolf one. I don't think it'll help friendly things. You can wave and you can sit down and surrender and stuff like that. I mean, all those things, of course, have been in the previous games. In fact, if you play DayZ Epoch now, when you surrender, press the surrender button, it actually drops your gear on the ground for you so people can actually properly search you. Like, all of your gear, which is quite a cool addition. Sounds like there's somebody upstairs in here. You can hear them walking about. I don't know if that's another player, or maybe it's a zombie, like a zombie doctor that's in here, but... gonna give them a bash if they're a zombie. Yeah, you can hear them moving about upstairs. I shan't go up there. There's no need to antagonize. What is that? I thought that was a pistol then, but it's a... charcoal tab or something. I think that's used for settling your stomach. Like that rotten apple by there. If I'd ate that, I'd have said I got a funny taste in my mouth in the bottom left, and I was probably going to get poisoned by it. So you want to avoid eating rotten stuff. But I found some dead survivors with just a backpack full of rotten fruit. Like, I don't know. They were collecting all for like the world's worst fruit salad or something. I thought that was a bandage there. But bandages are like little round things now. Like tubular ones that... well, the hospital have in them. The other cool thing you can actually do with medical stuff like this saline drip thing is you can take them and you can put them all into a first aid kit like you'd actually carry when you were trekking in your backpack to save space. And then you have to get the first aid kit, like put it into your hands, and then you can sort of access the stuff in it whilst it's in your, you know, like you'd actually take some out of your backpack and hold it in your hands, and that is a big improvement over how the mod is. I'm kind of hoping there's nobody on the roof of here. I feel that would be the place that a bandit would, you know, sit up there and then shoot anybody with his M4 who came through here, but... I thought that was a compass hanging in the wall there, but... it's just a light switch. Not very homely, these barracks here. There's something under the bed. So I gotta check all the... oh, a tan tactical shirt! I'm super camouflaged, and you can use it as bandages as well if you rip it up. Somebody will still see me if they're playing on low though. Got a fucking M4. What's this? What's this one? So you got to check what things are. That's ruined, and that's pristine.
Damaged. Worn. Badly damaged. Worn is less than badly damaged, I think. I put some magazines in my top and everything. It's going to be... I don't think I've got any ammo, though. But this is the new M4. I had a different stock in it. Like, you can change out all the parts of the gun, but as you can see, can't really do anything with this. So, it's best to just put it away and hope nobody thinks you've got a gun and then shoots you for it. Made in USA! You see, looting takes a lot longer because you've got to, like, actually check under things, which I suppose is cool, but I just feel that there's a little bit less loot than I would have imagined would be in a... If I can find a magazine, that'd be great, and I can actually show you how these guns work. No, at the moment, I'm just going to have to stick with my baseball bat. I don't know if this is boring you guys. It's the only way I could think of doing this video to show you what the standalone is currently like. If I edit it up, it doesn't show you. So if you want edited, don't be perturbed. No, that's not the right word. Deterred. I should know better than that. But don't be deterred, because the next episode will be a proper entertaining one. Oh! Oh, that goes on top! So I've got an assault vest on top of everything now. I'm gonna be good if somebody kills me. I've never had such cool gear! You see, my gun is on this side as well, on the back. Melee combat is a little bit, dodgy. Is probably the right word for it. It's a bit dodgy at the moment, unfortunately. So I'm going to put away my baseball bat. You can also punch, like this. It doesn't do very much damage, but you can, like, Rocky Balboa somebody if you wanted to. Thing is, if I attack that zombie, it's probably going to make... Oh shit, there's more barracks up here. I've never been here before. Oh, that was a vicious popping. I might actually have to kill this zombie, though. I'll show you combat. See, it's a bit sort of bad, to be honest, at the moment. It doesn't make a very satisfying sound. I am definitely beating the crap out of her. You see, she just doesn't want to go down. And then when you bleed, I mean, there are a fucking pain in the ass, these zombies. Oh, finally. How kind. I'm hungry, thirsty, and bleeding. You see all that in here, by the way, if you're wondering. Now, have I got any bandages? Nope. So you know what I've got to do? I've got to take off my beautiful tan shirt, which should be... Oh, it's disappeared again. I feel warm blood on my clothes. Of course you do, because everything I fucking take off just disappears into the ground. Well, we might die here. This will be an adventure. But let's see if I can find a jumper or a jersey or something to rip up. Because you can rip up your shirt into bandages. This might do. I'm not entirely sure why I can't rip up trousers. I'm sure they would work as just a good bandage. Nope. You see, it's unfortunate things like that, which mean... No, I can't rip up my assault vest either. And it seems food doesn't give you back blood as well. Please be a shirt! Yay! Tear into rags! Okay, so I've torn that into rags and I can use that. Why I'm trying to split these, don't even ask. Can I bandage him? Am I going to bleed to death? I hate these messages in the bottom left. They're one thing I really hate in this. Am I actually bandaging him? Yeah, okay, I'm bandaged. But now you see, I've basically, unless I meet somebody who's got a blood bag, or I take blood off, I'm basically grey screen until then. Like, I can't, there's no wildlife to catch in the woods apart from rabbits. And, I don't want to run Kiwi. Let's see what else Whiny Baby needs. He needs to eat. I feel like I'm, like when I'm playing this game, I'm just like nurturing some pathetic child. There's actually a dude out there, but he's probably going to kill me. Since we are on very low blood. Hello! Have you got a blood bag, dude?
Friendly, 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 guys, friendly!
I'm friendly!
Friendly guys.
Hello.
Everybody friendly.
Everybody's friendly. Have you got a blood bag?
I don't speak English very well.
Oh, I can tell that. Oh, there's another dude here. Oh no, you just glitched through the wall.
Maybe I'm out of the spawn.
Hello. Can anybody?
I don't know.
I don't kill you.
I don't know what this dude's doing. I'm engaging in teamwork with him. He doesn't know, though. I shall force teamwork upon him. Unless he accidentally hatches me. I feel that he probably will at some point, but since I'm on very low blood, we're just going to have to roll with this. Can you give me a saline drip if I put it in your backpack? Can you help me with the saline drip? Let me put it in your backpack. I don't know how to do this. I've got a saline drip on me. Can you access my backpack? Can you try giving me this saline over here? Look, here on the floor. Look, there. Can you give me that? Can you inject me with that and give it me? It's called saline. You can press tab to bring it up. Can you try giving me that? Well, that was a hell no. Just fucking run off with it. Oh, he's come back. Can you give it me? Can you heal me? Oh, I don't know what to do with it. I'm sure these things come with a needle you can just stick in people's arms. Oh, he's just fucked off with them and that apple. He even stole my apple! Why, Rodrigo? Why? Okay, so she lost the tracking at that kind of distance. It's quite a way. It is very laggy coming into here. It appears nobody's been in here though, which is unexpected to say the least. Is that a book? Maybe that's just a. What do these do? Oh, we're right-clicking there. Did I add some more in here? Activate carbon formula used to trap chemicals. Stop. Okay, so they kind of stop me from getting poisoned then, I guess. Oh, another M16. I've got so many. So I've got to take it into my hands and then... let's see what I want to take off it, so... so that's a badly damaged one. And if I click on the S, it just drops it, which is quite intuitive. I like how they've got all the gear and stuff stood up properly, though. That's nice. Oh, magazine! At last! Can I attach you? Right. Oh, those are under there. Take autumn hunter pants. What pants have I got? Cargo pants on. Let me just move all this junk into here. And I could switch over my pants. I don't know what I'm going to do with the duct tape and stuff. Yeah, maybe I can duct tape some magazines together or something. So I've got quite a lot of spare stuff. It seems they've actually slowed down your hunger and thirst. So I have to... I'll take that as well. So, let me get out of this gum. Let me try it. I'm going to go and try it on a zombie. I don't know how you tell how much ammo you've got. It says 100 for some reason in the top right. But it's definitely not 100. And for some reason, when you duct tape two mags together, it gives you... This is the prison. This has probably got some stuff in as well. When you duct tape two mags together, it gives you like...
Don't shoot, please.
Bro, you were trying to get in a sneaky hatchet right then. You could have talked to me at any point. You knew I was there and you were making a beeline for me because you thought I hadn't seen you. Looks like he's got an M4 on his back as well. It's okay, dude, you can bandage, but I'm going to need you to blood bag me in a second. Once you've sorted that out. And then we can heal each other. Alright? I'm just going to keep an eye on this guy. Because if I hadn't shot him just now, he'd have hatcheted me right there at those doors. But... I'm just going to see if we can blood bag in this room. There's actually some gear in here. Oh, there's a head torch there. Dude, give me the magazine. Give me the magazine. I can't let you run around with a magazine, man. Drop the mag. When you blood bag me, you can have it back. But we need to figure out how to blood bag first, okay? Why, you know that I'm trustworthy and you're not. Okay, you can have that mag when we've blood bagged and I've gone away, because then I know that we're trustworthy between us. Okay? Is there any way you can give me a blood bag? I don't understand how they work yet. So can I collect a sample off you, or do I have to collect it off myself to make this blood bag? Let's see. Let's see what this does. Oh, apparently nothing is left. Apparently we can't. Okay, I think to collect blood off you, the item's got to be in my hand, dude. But the difficulty is, you've still got an axe on your back. So I tell you what we'll do. You come out here and drop the axe outside, and then we'll do that, and you can blood bag me, and you can have your magazine back. Yeah? So come outside with me. Oh, you've dropped it. Okay, let's go back in here. Come back in here. Okay. Well, that's weird. It actually doesn't let me do it. I've got a syringe. Okay, I'm collecting. This is weird.
Okay.
What the fuck? This is so weird. Now what do I do with it? It doesn't seem to do anything. I don't understand. Can I...
Try to run for me.
Oh, I'm collecting, dude. You're going to have none left. Dude, we're going to be best mates. We're going to be best mates after this. We've got each other's blood now. That almost killed you. Oh my god. For fuck's sake, this is crazy. I'll tell you what though, dude, you're making a good video. So now can you give me that blood bag kit if I
combine with 4 stealth kit that blood bag.
I'm not entirely sure where the blood the blood bag's on the floor somewhere. I think it takes a second for it to appear. Holy shit, this is like a proper medical operation. Ah, there it is. Blood bag's on the floor. Now, can you give me that? Can you give that to me?
Okay, I have. And here you go.
Is this actually working? You gave me a blood transfusion. It did nothing, but it's that was awesome. You got the wrong type of blood. Oh my god. Oh, I love this game. I love this game.